shoebox. Oh, you can store stuff in shoeboxes. Okay, that's cool. Okay, let's continue on. And okay, I'm out. Oh shit, I'm outside.
The payphone was ringing. Somehow I knew the call was for me.
The phone is ringing. Who is it? Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Wake.
Yeah, who are you?
Yes.
Do you know who I am?
No. Who is this?
We'll get to that later. There are spies all over. Shadows.
A sense of deja vu washed over me. Had I had this conversation before?
Alan, listen to me carefully. Caldera Street Station, the subway. You need to go there. I'll call you again later. Make sure to pick up.
Do I know you? I know you from somewhere.
You've just forgotten again. We're in it together. Don't worry. I got it now. We've been working.
I'm losing you. Hello?
Got myself a free subway pass. Let's go! They're lost. So, I'm not liking the vibe of it. It looks very Casey. Okay, so spoilers on who the phone is. It's Alex Casey.
The man had said Caldera Street Station. I had to go there.
So this is the dark place. In between with Mr. Door.
The dark place wouldn't let me go that way.
Whoa, that's trippy as fuck. He just went pitch black. I need a flashlight and a gun. Subway. Oh, sorry, I'm guessing the street signs help. I don't even have a weapon. I can't go that way either. Hey, look. Hard, Casey.
There was someone there, but there was no one. I wanted to keep it that way.
This is where I'm meant to be going? Yep.
Is this the way it was on the page?
What the hell?
Hey, it is Alex Casey.
We met at Door's show.
Alan Wake, the writer. I'm Alex Casey, looking into a murder.
Come on, what is this?
There's a piece of evidence, a manuscript of a novel. You wouldn't know anything about it?
A manuscript? What manuscript? I need to see it.
Rumor had it the manuscript contained the details of the murders. The murder cult was...
So this isn't Sam Lake. It's Sam Lake, but the character meant to be Alex Casey, the real Alex Casey.
Had he written it? How far would he go to create a perfect work of art? Or would he be the next victim?
Chance.
He did. Damn. Well, flashlight. Yay. And a gun. Shit's about to go down now.
This was an echo of the books I had written for years. Picking up Casey's gun felt like I was assuming the role of the detective. I had a light now. I could use it to make my way deeper.
Just loop around. Okay, what if I... Hills? So that was pretty much nothing, okay. But I think, I'm pretty sure I need the light though. Taking the light with me.
Shit. With the alley in darkness now, the rest of the shadows block my way. Flashlight, I could find that.
Bam. I've played Alan Wake before. Oh, I thought that said stocks, but it says books. Ooh. I'm going down there. There goes station. Oh, what's all the way over here though? Well, that just disappears.
The Caldera Street station sign was there, but the entrance was missing. I had to make it appear. Maybe I could use the lamp to reveal the station entrance.
a map. No. It's telling me to go that way. What if I don't want to go that way, hmm?
Hello?
Oh.
Hey, oh, shit!
You snuck up on me.
Sorry. Have we met?
Memory problems again, huh? Yeah, we've met. Tim Breaker. We've shared notes. Hey, I've made some progress on the map, if you want to take a look.
But this is where he came from.
You're making a map.
Trying to. It's hard to map a dream, though. I keep ending up in unexpected places. I find interesting things like those strange markings that react to the light. But never the one thing that I'm looking for. Feel free to check the map out. Oh, I've been stockpiling supplies while I poke around. If you find a stash, take anything you need.
I appreciate the help. Who's this mystery man?
Oh, it wouldn't be much of a mystery if I knew. All I have is a name. Warland Dorr.
The talk show host?
No, that doesn't sound like him. The guy has many disguises, but a talk show host? I'll keep looking.
It's definitely the talk show host, but look at him. So he's came here. So this is where he is.
Well, that's my crazy wall. I'm just trying to make sense of things. Don't judge me.
I'll trade you walls any day.
Goes by many names. Wallendor. Definitely the talk show host. Isn't here then? Oh, good old. Nice. Okay. Oh wait, what's in here? Supplies. Ooh, trauma. Pack, medkit. Do I need to crew across there? Yeah, I'm guessing so. Cause... empty. Okay. Great. I can climb that, but I can also go in here. Ah, I'm meant to go down here. Here we go.
The gates to the platform were closed. I had a ticket.
There we go.
Something about the station platform felt significant. It would work in my writing, but I needed more. Something lingered here. A half-forgotten memory. An echo.
FBI agent had come here before me on the trail of a murder cult. He'd gone missing. Presumed dead. The cult was leaving me clues to follow, connecting the dots from one murder to the next, inviting me to draw an obscene picture on the city map. Caldera Street Station. The name made me think of the exit wound of a bullet.
I had a flash of inspiration. The ghost of my fictional detective. A story thread I could use in my writing. I had a location. I had a story thread. I would put them together, write them into my story to create a path deeper into the dark place.
Ah!
Things clicked into place. The story rang true. I was making progress. The dark place reacted to my story. The way into the tunnels was no longer blocked.
That's cool. Wait, so do I have any more? Here you go, plot board.
The story thread felt right here.
That's actually really cool. So it's definitely not down this way. Unless, ooh, but these open up to give me stuff.
That had glimpsed into the maw of darkness. It swallowed him whole.
Someone got murked.
Led into the tunnel. That was my way forward.
So if I get a...
The blood trail continued deeper into darkness.
Guessing in here. It's a crime scene. Oh, fuck.
Shit.
My reaction, exactly. I came from there. Okay, nothing bursting open through the wall. Oh, thank goodness. It means I need to go this way. Can't jump it. There's a door there. Yeah, I can't go that way. Okay, through the door. It's locked. Sure. Interesting.
I had to be at the scene to see and understand it in order to change it.
So, where to?
There was something hidden here. Light would reveal it. A phrase repeated over and over. The words resonated with meaning. Had I written this?
Well, words of power. Ah, here we go. You're meant to go in here.
The tunnels were a maze. The blood trail led me on.
I'm gonna have to steer a light. I'm guessing that light down there.
Another place to use in this story. I needed to search the tunnels for further visions.
Okay.
Inspiration for the story that would lead me deeper. I had a new location for the story. This thread fit the scene. I changed the story.
Nope.
And with that,
okay.
The dark place changed.
Nope. Guess I'm gonna have to go that way. I don't like the scream though. Oh wait.
It's bad luck to be on this case. The cult can get you anywhere with that black magic.
The federal
shit.
Agent had come here looking for answers. All we found
was
a fate worse than death.
Some fed came looking for the cult, but it was a trap. A satanic blood sacrifice.
Anyone who gets involved with the cult.
Wait, that Alan?
I heard their leader is this
famous
writer, Alan Wake.
That's what they're talking about, man.
Your unholy motherfucking messiah.
Sounds like a load of bull.
Nothing here. Why do that? Batteries, that. Sweet, I think. Oh, and another one. With nothing. But I can't steal this light, though.
Another echo lingered here. A source of inspiration.
These tunnels for their ritual sacrifices. They say the cult reenacted the murders in Alan Wake's crime books. The Wake.
I had a new idea, a new story thread. I couldn't add a new element from here. I'd have to go to the scene.
Okay, let's go to the scene then. But I can go down to that water thing and use the light now, though.
Was gone. The way forward was open.
Okay. Am I meant to be going this way with this factory story path? I think it's the story path.
In case you don't remember again.
I know, Tim. I'm remembering more now.
It's good to hear, man.
How's your search for Mr. Dorr going?
It's not great. This dream we're in. Putting a lot of roadblocks in my way.
The sketch you have does look like the Dorr I know. The talk show host.
All I know is the Dorr has something to do with what's happening to me. And he knows that I know. He's like some sadistic mastermind torturing me.
So you think this is a dream?
I'm not ruling it out. You know, my dreams have always been incredibly vivid. They feel real until the second I wake up. In dreams, I'm often someone else, a different person, with a different name, living a different life in a different world. Alternate realities, maybe.
Quantum break.
But certain things don't change. Like Dorr.
That is unknown. I'm guessing, yeah.
Imagine this murder cult performing their macabre acts beyond the collapsed tunnel. The cultists laid the Casey novel onto the altar with reverence. Their twisted Bible.
Damn. Okay, let's go back to the other way then. Okay, let's go up here. Oh, ah! Fuck! Back, demon! Fuck me, dead. Why did I not see that coming? Yes.
Memory is fading like a dream. I must hold on to the truth. I will
You need help. Good luck.
The train blocked my way forward, but it was here for a reason. It had a role to play.
Okay, gotta rewrite the events again.
New scene to use. A new setting. Gasoline over the train car. An iron cage that would soon become a coffin.
Go on, ma'am.
This is where the history of the cult gets genuinely disturbing. The cultists track down the torchbearers living in the tunnels, lock the poor folks up in a derailed subway car, douse them in gasoline.
It could not be opened
on
the side.
It turns into a bit of a ghost story after that. They say the dark smoke from the fire still roams the tunnels searching for new victims to devour.
What if I want this?
Hello? Anyone there? Dead.
The scene changed with the story. The subway car had become a burnt husk. I could get through it now.
Okay, let's go through it then. Oh, yeah. Damn. They're nice and toasty.
This was real.
It was. Don't make me hear it. Nope. Didn't want to hear that.
Fuck me.
Shortcut. I wonder if I went, what happens if I went back to that other site?
I had to figure this out on the plot board.
Like, what would happen if I went to the other site and used the torchbearer thing there, the ritual area? Changed, all right.
Torchbearers painted the tree there. The tree of knowledge. The tree of life with its roots reaching down to hell.
Yggdrasil.
It could have been a Christmas tree for all the good it did him.
Huh? Oh, here we go. Nope. What? Ah, here we go. Oh shit! Brought me back all the way around here. Maybe it...
My path was blocked. I had to find a way through.
Well, the door right here, though. Hmm. Save everything.
Changing a plot element in a scene without being there was impossible.
If I change it to the FBI, that's what I might have to do. Not still nothing.
I should look at the plot board. Keep the story moving.
There we go. There's that way.
I was sure the plot board had the pieces I needed.
I know. Okay,
the
end of the line.
Ball had a story to tell.
We'll go back and we'll use the three.
I had a new idea for a scene.
Nothing though. Chairs in the middle. This is opened. Hemingway. So that's everything for that. Would not. Okay. We'll try Torchbearer.
The plot changes shape the world around me. Into the murder cult's hideout.
Here we go.
The cultists were close now, a dark presence rising from the depths.
Alex Casey novels.
Scared. Whether the summoning ritual had been a bona fide supernatural event or the mass psychosis of stark raving lunatics.
Stark? Journey Stark?
The facts. The cult was messing with things no one should mess with.
The ritual was a vital part of the story. The key to reaching the murder site.
I don't like this anymore.
Wake.
No, that's not me. He moans as well. Why do they moan? Nothing. Great.
Look at the blackboard to figure out a way forward.
There we go. Anything in here? No. Here we go.
The tunnels. Turns out the cultists weren't the only ones using the tunnels. Hidden graffiti signs marked secret routes. I kept hearing whispers around burn barrels of an underground society of mystic outsiders with hidden knowledge. Typical New York.
Had to be at the scene to see and understand.
Wake. The story is a monster. Wake.
No, not me. Not me. I'm not Wake. I'm not Alan Wake. I'm not Alan Wake. Safe room. And save. Back out here. I have no idea where I am. Can't go down that way. So this way. Here we go, I can get deeper into the story here. Whoa. Oh, fuck! Run!
Fuck!
Get to that room!
I couldn't hear the dark presence. It was gone.
I'm going back there. I guess I'm going back. Run, Alan! Bolt it! Leg it! You call this running?
The dark presence. I had seen it before. I remembered now. It was always out there, haunting me.
What the fuck is this place? Whoa.
I found a murder site. Somehow.
Oh shit!
The was the key.
I saw penis again. Great. Oh my god, great.
I was closer to home.
But that happened moments before.
Something had changed outside Parliament Tower, where I'd lived with Alice. It was out there, waiting for me.
Ooh. Am I meant to leave?
Who was writing who? Who was writing this poem? Me? No.
Stepping to the murder site, I'd felt it.
Oh shit. What? How am I meant to get it? There we go.
The station had changed. I was closer now.
Taking the light with me.
Last line. Tower. Our home in New York. Was I really this close to being home? Going up to our apartment? Would I be home? Or was this just an echo of the real thing?
Ooh. Phone is ringing. The
sight had brought me one step. Helping me.
Did you go deeper to the overlap?
Are you talking about the murder site? Yeah, I did. I...
That's fantastic, Alan. We're closer to getting out. We're making progress.
Well, we would be if you would answer my damn questions.
Last time we spoke, you were pretty worried about Alice. Did you ever check Parliament Tower to make sure she really got out of the dark place?
Well, of course she got out. That's why I'm here. That's the whole goddamn point. Wait, hello?
So who is that? It's not Alex Casey, he's dead. Man got bapped.
Monster behind it all. Either way, Alice Wake, his ex, she knew things. It was there in her art for all to see. A cry for help. The darkness she'd witnessed. And that put her in danger.
Was Alice here? In the story?
Uh-oh. Hunting.
Alice's photo equipment set to go off when the door opens.
Get Alice! Leave me alone!
Alice! Alice! Alice.
For exhibition posters.
This is the door to my study, where I wrote my books. The symbol wasn't here before.
Oh, what? Video article. Focal point of the dark place.
Alice's video camera. No memory card inside.
So I have to look for the memory card. Got it. I can do that.
This is a photo of Scratch.
That's Scratch. Get this?
Is he stalking her?
Okay, yeah, definitely not in there. Now, where's this memory card?
Memory card.
When I was younger, photography was everything to me. I moved to New York thinking I'd make it as an artist. And then I met Alan. We had a good thing. We were both dedicated by our creative ambitions. The only difference was that Alan's work made money. He brought me work when he could. I took his promo shots, created covers for his books.
Oh, that's nice of him.
Sure, he forced his publisher into it.
Aww. That's a good husband.
I was taking photos, just not my photos. And that nod at me. Things got complicated sometimes, but that's life, right? We loved each other. Then meaner side of him, one I didn't like. I set up a trip to see a doctor in Washington. I didn't tell him until we got there.
The Hartman.
We argued. Things went wrong. Years ago, I started hearing noises in the night. Typewriter keys clacking. Voices. Alan was back.
What?
Haunting me.
Aww, she thought she was being haunted. Well, the lamp in the back is still flickering, so you probably are being haunted.
My nightmares caught on film. And
Alice. Scratch was terrorizing her. Why?
Uh-oh. Scratch. Oh shit, he's dead. Scratch. So I'm playing as Anderson now. Yep.
Okay, let's recap what you've told us so far, Ellen. For the past 13 years, you've been trapped in a nightmare dimension called the Dark Place. Yeah. It's like New York, but it's not New York. And can be reached from the bottom of Cauldron Lake, but it's not really under the lake. And after all this time, you've managed to get out.
Yeah, yeah.
But so has your evil doppelganger, Mr. Scratch? Or is it the Dark Presence?
Both. It's interchangeable. He's Scratch when he looks like me, but he can change into this other form.
And Scratch, the Dark Presence, wants to rewrite the world in his own image.
Which would be in your image. As he looks just like you.
And turn the world into a fucking nightmare.
During Deerfest, which is scheduled to take place in a couple of days.
Yep.
You got out of the Dark Place by writing a novel, the pages we've been finding. But your double edited it into a horror story that's now changing reality, taking over people,
yeah.
Making them crazy, bringing the Dark Place to Bright Falls.
Yes. Fiction coming in contact with the Dark Place can change reality. The story is coming true, soaking into everything, like darkness when night falls. But last time it...
This will be back in 2010.
Yes, last time it didn't happen all at once. The story came true bit by bit as it unfolded. And that dark presence was still bound to the lake. I stopped it before it got the ending it wanted. Before it broke free. Based on that, there's still time.
Which brings us to your magical light switch.
It doesn't quite cover it. Scratch wants it to bring about his ending. That can't happen. If I can get the clicker, I can send him back to the dark place, make all this shit go away. Look, I know it's batshit crazy. My memory is full of holes, and I'm not sure how much I can trust. It's like a half-forgotten dream.
Why are they drinking at the exact same time? That's just hilarious.
Mr.
Mr. Wake.
You're under arrest now.
Alan. We've seen our share of batshit crazy in the past 24 hours. What I want to know is, why am I? Why are we written into the story?
I think I saw you. A vision of you in the dark place. I think you helped me reach out and escape somehow. With that in the story, Scratch would have edited it to get to you. To hurt you. We are all in danger.
Gotcha.
It's insane. And there's so much of it.
You call it the tree.
Wake just gave us a lot of information. But this clicker seems like a good place to start. If we find that, then we find the cult.
Yeah, you're gonna be looking for a rot a while. Symbol. That would that also be a symbol? No. There we go. And what's this? This. There we go. But there's more cases. Here we go, the story.
The pages we've been finding are from a horror story called Return, written by Alan Wake. And the contents of this book are coming true. Why couldn't it have been a romance?
Whoa, that's a lot of stuff. Yeah, they will be there. The dark place. Then this one, that was the dark presence, is this that?
Doesn't make sense.
Last time it didn't happen all at once. The story came true bit by bit as it unfolded.
Keep trying.
There we go.
Have you ever heard of the Cult of the Tree?
Creepy bunch. In the habit of wearing deer masks, performing murder rituals, victims turning into monsters possessed by darkness. Possibly inspired by a horror story written by a certain author. Ring any bells?
The cult. Yes. Yes. They have the clicker.
If the cult has the clicker, does that make them Scratch's followers? How are you so certain they even have the clicker?
They could be working for Scratch. I don't remember. It's all confused.
Alan, if I'm gonna act on this information, you need to be honest with me.
Yeah, of course.
Is he confused? Or is he hiding something?
No, he's confused. He's not hiding anything. I don't think he's hiding anything.
Wake has more information. I need to keep questioning him. Wake has a double. Mr. Scratch. Where is he now?
A cloud of wrath wears my face. The dark place in your place. Scratching out my body of work.
Scratch is here. In Washington. He's hunting Wake. Wake said the cult has the clicker. How does he know?
The writer is the reader. The next chapter, the next chapter, the next chapter. Keep the pages safe, the dark shining of the words.
Wake is hiding pages. That's how he knows the cult has the clicker. Scratch looks just like Wake. Why?
Don't wake up the dreamer if your life is a dream. I swam to the shore, but the water is rising.
Wake and Scratch are clearly connected.
Yeah, because the...
Maybe Scratch got out because Wake did. Or vice versa.
Yeah, probably. Here we go, cases. Cult of the Tree.
Okay, Mr. Wake, I know you have more pages of the manuscript on you.
You don't understand how vital these pages are. They're the only way I can know what's coming.
You're not the only one trying to solve this. This is our job.
Okay. Here. This is all I have. Be careful with them.
Inside the trailer, at the outskirts of Watery, Saga had seen Wake's fabled clicker for the first time, in the hands of the Cult of the Tree. A cultist stared at her. She drew a weapon.
Okay. Guessing I need to do this first.
The cult of the tree has the clicker Wake told me about. They're a part of all this. It's all on the page. The clicker, the cult. Okay, I'll head to Watery and find this trailer. Casey, you stay here and keep an eye on Mr. Wake.
Got it.
No, you need me there.
No dice, pal. This is an FBI investigation, and I don't see a badge on that flannel.
Oh, so that's how you can swap in between. I can also manual save. Hey. Okay, so I'm actually going to end this episode of Alan Wake 2 here. Make sure to like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.